Hi, my name is Karen Bowers. I'm a teacher at Duval High School. Interpreting our book today is Ashley Nance. Today I'm reading the book A Chance for Esperanza, written by Pam Schiller and illustrated by Mike Jurasco. We have sign names for the story: Esperanza. The sign name is that. Abuela, abuela, the sand is cracking. Tonight is the night. Ivan, Ivan, the sand is cracking. Tonight's the night. You're right, Austin. Let's go ahead and ask everyone to turn the lights out tonight. We want the moonlight over the ocean to be guiding lights for these little guys. Lights on the beach might distract them. And you, make sure you have strong batteries in your flashlight, said Ivan, as he patted Austin on the shower and winked at Abuela. Abuela, Austin said seriously, I want to hear the story about Esperanza again. It will help me be ready tonight. I'm going to help every little turtle make it to the sea. You have always loved the story of Esperanza. I'm happy to tell it to you as often as you like. Before you were born, before your mother and father were married, I came to Callium to visit your mother. She was working in a dive shop. I fell in love with this village and the people who live here. After the night on the beach when we set the turtles free, I knew that I would return again and again and again. A long time ago, the turtles swam freely in the ocean. For thousands of years, there were many, many sea turtles. Then people built homes and big hotels on the beaches where the turtles laid their eggs, and the turtles no longer had a safe place for their nests. Soon, the number of turtles began to decrease, and there were fewer and fewer turtles in the ocean. I'll start the story, Abuela. You're too slow. One night, some mother sea turtles came up upon the beach and laid their eggs. Early the next morning, my mother and Ivan walked along the beach looking for tracks and small mounds of sand that would indicate a turtle's nest was buried below. The first nest they found had already been robbed by birds and crabs. There was nothing in it except empty eggshells. But they found another nest that the animals had not discovered yet. You tell the rest, Abuela. Ivan and your mother carefully dug up the eggs, all of them. They put them in a pail, and Ivan counted 78 eggs. They carried the eggs to Callium to the turtle nursery. They dug a hole in the protected area, and they dug a deeper hole than the mother turtle had dug, and then they buried the eggs. When they were finished, they stuck a stick in the middle of the nest as a marker to help them find that nest later. They wrote the date on the marker so that they would know when to expect the babies to hatch. Many days later, about 60 in all, the sand around the marker began to crack, and Ivan knew that the baby turtles were hatching and wiggling out of their shells. He carefully dug the babies up from their nest and placed them in a box to keep them safe until nightfall. When the sun went down, it was time to release the turtles. Ivan told everyone to turn off their lights and come to the beach. You were one of the people on the beach that night, Abuela.
Yes, Austin. I went to the beach to watch the baby turtles crawl to the sea. Your mother was there, too. It was her job to tell the story of how the mother turtle had laid her eggs and how she and Ivan had reburied them to keep them safe.
Your mother told the people to make two lines so that everyone could see the turtles as they made their way to the sea. She explained that the journey from the box to the ocean was an important part of the release because it helped the turtles develop the rhythm of their crawl and it helped them strengthen their legs. They needed strong legs for swimming. My mother let the turtles out of the box, right, Abuela? Your mother released the turtles, and Ivan used his flashlight to help guide them to the sea. Some of the turtles went straight to the water, didn't they?
Yes, some went straight to the water, but other turtles were confused. They crawled in the wrong direction. Ivan used his flashlight to get them turned around.
Soon, all the turtles were in the ocean except for one, and you wanted to pick it up and help her, didn't you?
I wanted to help her, but Ivan said she had to make it on her own.
He said if she couldn't make it into the water on her own, she would not be strong enough to survive in the ocean. When a turtle didn't make it to the ocean, it was left on the beach. You asked Ivan if you could borrow his flashlight, didn't you?
Yes, I took the light and put it close to the turtle's eyes. When I did, I saw that her eyes were crusted over with sand. She couldn't see. I picked her up and I wiped her eyes and put her back down again. In a short time, she began to move. Soon she began to crawl more quickly, and eventually she reached the ocean and swam away, looking just like her brothers and sisters who had gone ahead of her.
You wanted to name her Dilly Dally because that's what she had done. But Ivan said you should call her Esperanza, which means hope in Spanish. He said, if one woman has this much hope for one turtle, there is hope for all the turtles.
Ivan and your mother have released many turtles over the years. Without their help, most of the turtles would have died. Tonight, you will help, and you will be the hope for the turtles.
Have a great summer and make sure you read.